dressing on anyone?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. All over.
What's that made out of?
You know, I know.
All right. Aaron Rodgers is asking fans to link hands.
Asking fans?
Uh-huh.
All right. That's a first.
Mm. On Thursday.
Bears, in Packers. The stands. Bears, Packers.
Uh-huh. He's asking Packers fans who are going to the game on Thursday night for a favor. He spoke to the media after practice on Tuesday, said the Packers will continue to link arms before the game on Thursday versus the Chicago Bears, just as they did on Sunday versus the Cincinnati Bengals. And now he's asking the fans in attendance to do the same thing.
All right.
It's never been about the military or our men and women in uniform. This is a quote from him. Like I said, after the game, we love and support them, and each of us, I'm sure, have done charity events for them. I've been to Fort Wainwright in Alaska and done PT with those guys at 5 in the morning, and we love them.
Mm-hmm.
PT, is that physical therapy?
Yeah.
We're thankful for the opportunity they give us. This is about equality. This is about unity and love and growing together as a society and starting a conversation around something that may be a little bit uncomfortable for people. But we've got to come together and talk about these things and grow as a community, as a connected group of individuals in our society. And we're going to continue to show love and unity. And this week, we're going to ask the fans to join in as well. And come together and show people that we can be connected and we can grow together.
All right. I like how he's phrased that.
Yeah. I don't. When did it become about the military? I missed that.
Yeah.
I mean, I know Colin Kaepernick said it was, you know, the flag and all that, but the flag is merely a symbol.
Right. It's not.
It's a symbol for what the military is fighting for, which is. Our freedom, our constitution, mm-hmm. and usually they're fighting in places where people don't have the right to speak freely. So
good point.
Yep.
All right. Well, that'll be interesting to see what happens.
So what, you know, one of the big names of the NFL speaking, you know, taking a
powerful yeah. Where's Glennon on this, man? I'd like to get Glennon's take on it if anybody knows what it is.
Long investigation into a fatal I-80 crash in the Joliet area wraps up and the road is open again. News next, but first the Weather Channel forecast.
Sunny and hot out here again this afternoon, but cooler air due in tomorrow. High this afternoon in the low 90s. Stray shower, a thunder shower possible overnight as we drop into the upper 50s. And then sunny and cooler Wednesday, low 70s. From the Weather Channel, I'm meteorologist Ken Boone, WLSAM 890 with another update in 30 minutes.
It's 90 degrees in Chicago. One person was killed and two others were injured in a three-vehicle crash this morning on I-80 that left the road closed through this afternoon. Our Nick Gale has more.
The crash happened around 6:12 this morning on eastbound I-80 near Larkin Avenue in Joliet. It involved three commercial vehicles, including a FedEx truck that was hauling double trailers. The driver of that rig was killed. Witness Miguel Fernandez drives the route on a daily basis. He tells ABC7.
All I seen was a big old fireball, and next thing I know, when I started passing by, I seen three semis, actually two of them were on fire. The other one was disintegrated from the front. Also, I seen there was a man that came out one of the semis, and he was on fire.
The other two drivers were taken to area hospitals. A spokesman for FedEx says they're cooperating with investigators and extend their thoughts to the families of those involved in the accident. Nick Gale, WLSAM 890 News.
When police tried to pull over a driver in Evergreen Park for a reported traffic violation early this morning, he took off and crashed into a pole several blocks away at 87th and South Honoree Streets in Chicago. The driver was thrown from the vehicle and died at the scene. His identity has not been released. Recently, one of the Chicago Board of Elections vendors had a data breach that made some personal information available publicly, but now Bill Cameron says there's a fix.
The solution is to simply stop using so much personally identifiable information. Jim Allen over the Board of Elections tells me it's going to be limited to this.
Name and address, but if you want to verify how old they are, we're going to supply the age, but we're not going to have the date of birth programmed in there, and we'll have the year of birth available, so you can still verify the person's age. If you're needing them to give the last two digits of their social security number, that still gives, if there were someone attempting to commit fraud, a 1 in 100 chance of getting that right. So we don't need the full 4 digits, and we never had the full 9 digits. That's important to point out. But, you know, except for 2 digits, and that's good enough.
And something else they'll stop collecting is your driver's license number. At City Hall, Bill Cameron, WLS, AM 890 News.
Two men have been charged in a carjacking that took place back in February in West Suburban Wheaton. Two residents on Gallant Court were robbed at gunpoint and their car stolen. Now, 26-year-old Carlos Moore is charged with armed robbery and aggravated carjacking. The Chicago man is being held in the DuPage County Jail. An arrest warrant with the same charges has been issued for 25-year-old Philip J. Smith of Chicago. He's in Cook County Jail on unrelated charges. WLS traffic at 5:32. The Edens right now out to Lake Cook Road, 16 minutes inbound from Lake Cook. That's a 40-minute trip. The Kennedy out to the junction. That's at 30 and out to O'Hare 45. Inbound from O'Hare to downtown, 52 minutes. And from the junction in 20. Eisenhower out to Wolf 50, out to Thorndale an hour 5. Inbound from Thorndale 1 hour, Wolf in 40. Stevenson out to the Tri-State 45, 1 hour out to the Veterans Toll. Inbound from the Veterans Toll 50 and from the Tri-State in 32. The Dan Ryan out to 95th a half hour, and it's a half hour inbound from 95th. As we mentioned, now open eastbound I-80 between I-55 and Larkin. The on-scene investigation of the earlier fatal crash has wrapped up. Eastbound 80-94 crash near Kennedy Ave is on the side. Next traffic update in 15 minutes. The WLS Money Report. Sales of new U.S. homes slumped in August. The Commerce Department says sales dropped 3.4% to a seasonally adjusted annual rate of 560,000. That follows a 5.5% decline in July. The Dow closed down almost 12 points. The NASDAQ was up 9, and the S&P 500 was flat. News on the hour, the half, and when it breaks. Continuous coverage at WLSAM.com. More Steve Dahl on the way, and our next report at 6 o'clock. I'm Jennifer Kuiper, WLSAM 890 News.
Chronic headaches, constant sinus infections, pain and pressure.
That's Karen. She suffered for years with chronic sinus infection.